Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the enzymes, right? So in last few classes we were discussing about the proteins, right? So how the enzymes are proteins and they are related to the protein, that we are going to discuss, and how enzymes are having the different property when it comes to its activity point of view, right? At which temperature, which situation they are active and they are losing their activity. What are enzymes? What is their role? That we are going to discuss, right? So coming to the enzymes, if you see these images, right? These are the diagrammatic images, or you can try to understand here, right? Like there will be the substrate and there will be the enzymes, right? So the substrate, specific substrate, only going to bind with the specific enzyme. Then only enzyme substrate complex will be there like this, okay? And the products will be there and they will be active. So here also you can see that how the drug and receptors, they are binding and they are showing the action. Like that only it is happening here. You can see this red one and yellow one with their proper structure. Here only they are going to bind. This yellow cannot bind here and this red cannot bind with the yellow place, right? So likewise it happened, substrate and enzyme, when they will bind at specific, these reactions will take place and at their enzymes are going to show their action into the body. So coming to the we'll try to understand the enzyme. Enzymes are organic catalyzed, right, which will initiate the reaction, biological reactions which produced in the body by living organisms or living cells, right? That's what. So many enzymes, it will be produced by the body, human body, right? So they perform many complex chemical reactions that make up life processes, right? Whatever that's what biochemical, so many biochemical reactions it is going on in the body, right? So enzymes playing the major role to conduct the biochemical reactions to process the life process, right? Enzymes are lifeless, and when isolated, they still exert their characteristic catalytic effect, right? So whatever the catalytic, they are known as the catalyst, and they are having to perform catalytic effect. So if you will isolate also from the source, then also they may show their characteristic catalytic effect. Only the thing is, we need to provide their circumstance in which they are active. Their chemical compositions varies, and they do so the several common properties that we are going to discuss in coming slides. They are colloids, soluble in water, dilute alcohol, but are precipitated by the concentrated alcohol. If it is dilute alcohol, they may be solute, or if you are using the concentrated one, they may form the PPT. Most enzymes act best at temperature between 35 degree centigrade to 40 degree temperature. Temperature above 65 degree centigrade, especially in the presence of moisture, destroy them. Whereas their activity is negligible at 0 degree centigrade. See here, three zone of the temperature we discussed, 35 to 40, they are active, right? Temperature above 65, they destroy, right? And when it is the 0 degree, they are negligible. Certain heavy metals, formaldehydes and free iodine, retard the enzyme's activity, right? So these are the another factors which will retard the activity of enzymes. Their activity is markedly affected by the pH also, not only temperature. It is affected by the pH of the medium in which they act, or by the presence of other substances in this medium. Whatever the medium we are using in vitro, so in that, they may also, what is the pH of that medium, the substances it has been mixed in that medium, these all vary the activity of enzyme or interfere the activity of enzymes. They are highly selective in their action. That's what in the image slide I shown you, that only specific substrate only can bind with the specific enzyme, that lock and key model you might have discussed in your inter classes, right? So same thing, right? That's what they are highly selective in their action. Only specific enzyme can show the specific action only in the body or in the outside also. When we try to classify them, the enzymes are proteins. Yes, that's what we are discussing here in the protein chapter, right? Having molecular weight from about 13,000 to 840,000. This is the range of the molecular weight of the different enzymes. At present, they are divided according to their action by a complex system established by the Commission on Enzymes of the International Union of Biochemistry, right? First, this IUB, that's all, International Union of Biochemistry, they have classified according to their action. Six major classes are categorized. Each has 4 to 13 subclasses. And each enzyme is assigned a systematic code number like BC, right? Composed of 4 digits, okay? So major classes, we can see into the here, this slide. The class type of reaction catalyzed, what kind of reaction they are catalyzing or initiating, or right, are the examples of which enzymes coming under this category. So coming to the number one, the class is oxidoreductase. Okay, oxidoreductase class of enzyme. What kind of reaction they catalyze? They are catalyzing the transfer of electrons. Okay, wherever transfer of electrons takes place, there this enzyme's role. So that is nothing but the hydride ions or hydrogen atoms supposed to be there. So examples of oxidoreductase enzymes, these are the dehydrogenase or oxidase. These two are the example of oxidoreductase type of enzyme. Second category, it is the transferase. So on a transferase, where they are having role, group transfer reactions. Wherever group transfer reactions occur in the human body, there this enzyme role, it is there. So examples of transferase, it is the transaminase and kinase. These two are the example. Third one under the classification, hydrolase. Okay, hydrolysis reactions, as the name indicates, hydrolysis reactions, transfer of functional group to water. Okay, so examples are esterase, digestive enzymes, whatever digestive enzymes, trypsin, chemotrypsin, pepsin, pepain, right, all those things. Then fourth class, that is the lyase. Okay, under this the reactions catalyze addition of groups to double bonds or formation of double bonds by removal of groups. These two types of catalytic reaction, they are playing the role. The examples are phosphohexoisomerase and fumarase. These two are the example. Fifth one, isomerase class. Under this, it participating in the transfer of groups within molecules to yield isomeric forms. Examples are decarboxylase and aldolase. These two are example of isomerase type of enzyme. Then sixth one, ligase. Here they are catalyzing the formation of carbon-carbon, carbon-sulfur, carbon-oxygen and carbon-nitrogen bonds by condensation reactions coupled to ATP cleavage. Okay, the examples are citric acid synthesis. Okay, citric acid synthesis. This is the example of ligase type of enzyme, right? So here it is as per the International Union of Biochemistry. They have classified the major things we have discussed here, which you can write in the exam. Then coenzymes also, it is there. What are the coenzymes? Enzymes are found in combination with inorganic or organic substances that have an important part in the catalytic action. If these are non-protein, non-protein organic compounds, they are known as coenzyme, right? That's what. These are a combination with the inorganic or organic substances. Okay, they are also important part for the different biochemical reactions. And what is the another thing? Non-protein organic compound, then we can consider them as a coenzymes. If they are inorganic ions, they are referred to as activators. That's what. Coenzymes are integral components of a large number of enzyme systems, right? They are essential part, we can say, right? Which will be there along with the enzymes. That's what they are co-host or co-author, like that coenzyme. Several vitamins like thiamine, riboflavin, nicotinic acid have a coenzymatic function. Enzymes are obtained from plant and animal cells, yes, and many have been purified. They are used as a therapeutic agent and controlling factors in the certain chemical reactions in industry, because that's what we need to isolate. Ultimately, the source of enzymes are what? Natural source only, plant or animal, right? And it is having industrial applicability. That's what we need to isolate them. We need to separate them and we have to maintain what is their natural requirement, like pH, temperature, and all those things. So here are some examples like pepsin, that is digestive enzyme, pancreatin, that is also digestive enzyme obtained from the pancreas of different animals. Then pepain are used therapeutically as digestants, or which will initiate that the digestion of different protein, lipid, carbohydrate, depend on the requirement. Then the hyaluronidase facilitates the diffusion of injected fluids. Streptokinase and streptodronase dissolve clotted blood and purulent accumulations. So these are the functions. Then jamase, it is another jamase and renin type of enzymes are used in the fermentation. And the cheese industries, that's what, right? Paneer and all those cheese items, it is because of these enzymes. Penicillinase inactivates the various penicillins, right? So that's what different enzymes we can use in the industry, in the pharmaceutical or non-pharmaceutical industry, like cheese industry, food industries, they are having a lot of role. So what are the properties that these are having this many roles and this many function over the inside the body or outside the body also? Enzymes are sensitive to heat and are denaturated by excess heat or cold. That's what temperature variation we have seen into the previous slides, right? That 15 to 16 degree centigrade, above 65 degree and 0 degree centigrade, how their activity it is interfering, right? Like their active site becomes permanently wrapped. Thus, the enzyme is unable to form an enzyme substrate complex. Until and unless enzyme it is not binding with the substrate, they are not going to show their action. This is what happens when you fry an egg. The egg white, that is the augmentin, a type of protein, not an enzyme, is denatured, right? That's what heat. When heat will increase, that's what, that is only we are discussing here, right? Excess heat, it is denatured by the excess heat or excess cold, right? So that's what, when we are frying the egg, what will happen? It will denatured, and your omelette or whatever that you are preparing, egg curry and all those things, that will happen. Enzymes are created in cells, but are capable of functioning outside of the cells. That's what it is having lots of industrial exposure. We need to isolate those enzymes. We have to preserve them. Whenever required, we can use them. This allows the enzymes to be immobilized without killing them, because there are also viable cells that will be immobilized and can be used. The third property we can see here, enzymes are sensitive to pH. That's what we could see. The rate at which they can conduct reactions is dependent upon the pH of where the reaction is taking place. What is the place? What is the medium? And in that medium, what is the pH? for example, pepsin that we are getting from the stomach, right? Pepsin in the stomach has an optimum pH of about 2, right? That's what in HCl will be secreting. So their acidic environment will be there, right? So whereas salivary amylase has the optimum pH of about 7, right? So in digestive system only, if you see the mouth where the saliva will be there, their pH is different. When it will go to the stomach, their pH is different. So that's what the activity enzymes, it will definitely interfere by the pH. At what pH it required? It required pH 2 or it required pH 7. So that's what pepsin in the stomach has the optimum pH 2. So that's what pepsin can be active at the stomach area only. The fourth property we can see here, enzymes are reusable and some enzymes are capable of catalyzing many hundreds or thousands of reactions. For example, you can see catalyze working on hydrogen peroxide, try putting some liver into hydrogen peroxide, right? So all those things, it is happening, thousands of reactions, it is going on. So where they are having the capability to conduct or catalyze them. Enzymes will only catalyze one reaction. There is no alternate. For example, invertase enzyme, all of you know, very much familiar about invertase, will only produce glucose and fructose when a glucose solution is passed over beads of enzymes. That's what in biotechnology, so many experiments, it is there, enzyme immobilization and plant immobilization techniques, all those things, right? Enzymes are capable of working in reverse. This act as a cutoff point for the amount of product being produced, right? So they are reversible reactions also, they are having capability, right? So this is the cutoff point of the amount of product where the reversible, right? If there are excess reactants, the number, the substance of for the reactions, excess reactant, the reactions will keep going and will reversed, so that there is no overload or built up of product. That's what, once it will go forward, then it will reverse. Reversible means reverse, it is coming back. That's what, right? So it is keep going until and unless whatever the things it is available as a reactant, the reaction will take place, then again it will be reversed. That's what, no overload or built up of products, unnecessary, it will not keep going on, right? Depend on the reactants. So here we could understand about the enzyme, what are the enzymes, what are the coenzymes, how the different properties of enzyme, it is having major role when we are expecting some activity or some action from the enzyme side. We need to take care about their temperature, their pH, and what are the things they require. Then only we can get the work from those enzymes as a catalytic action or as a catalyzed, right? That's what enzymes become very important, since it is obtaining from plant and animal source, and we have to isolate them, and we can take the work from them in industrial food industry, in pharmaceutical industry. We have seen the penicillinase, pencil, and invertase enzyme, and so many pepsin, trypsin, right? So that's what it is, the part of proteins.